Today, I'm going to show you how to take your headings from looking like this to looking like this. And we're going to do it with a little bit of CSS. It's painless. It's going to be really fun. And you can apply this in a lot of different ways throughout your website to give that website that custom look that you want. Follow me. I promise it's going to be simple. The code is in the description below. Okay, let's go. Let me first put on my eyes because your homegirl is blind. Okay. All right. Okay, so we're in your Shopify dashboard, all right? And this is a website that I've been playing with. I absolutely love coffee. I have an unhealthy addiction to it. And so this is my testing ground. I'm going to go ahead and pick a heading here. Let's start with our purpose, okay? So this section here is a rich text. So as you can see it from right here, the rich text section, but you can use this on any other section and I'll show you in a little bit. So let's go ahead and start off with our purpose. This is the one that I want to go ahead and change. So click on the section. So you're highlighting the full section because we're only applying the CSS just to this area, this heading specifically only. So we're going to go ahead and come to the bottom here where you'll find where it says CSS sometimes is, it's hidden. So just click on here for the CSS. And what you're going to do is you're going to copy and paste the code that I wrote down on the bottom for you. And we're going to go through it right now. For the H2, which is this one right here, stands for heading. Okay. And so for these sections here, these are your heading two. So that's what that is. So we're targeting this section here, this rich text section, and we're targeting only the heading, not this paragraph here below. The next line is your font. And so I'm using REMs because REMs is just, you have more consistency in the font sizes across all the devices and browsers and all of that. So it makes it nice and consistent. And so that's why I use it. You can go ahead and make this whatever size that you wanted to make. Okay. So let's say a 1 will be like equivalent to a 16, depending on your base code. So you can go ahead and play with this, what size you want it to be. We're going to go ahead and then I like the 3 and I also like the 4. But for now, for purposes here, so that you can have a really good visual of what this is, I'm going to go ahead and make it, let's do it 8. And see what I'm saying? You can play around with this. Don't be afraid, okay? So I'm going to make it nice and big so that you can really see what I'm doing here. So the second line is the color. So the color, this particular color is the font color, which is the green. Okay, so you can make this what match whatever your brand color is. So that's what you're going to enter here, okay? So remember in the description below, I'm going to have this here, but this is the green. So go ahead and change this to whatever your brand color is. So that is that. And then the second color is the actual shadow. So, and then the locations of the shadow. So the shadow right now is to the right, bottom, and then the glow of it, I guess you could say. So I have it really condensed right now, and I'm going to show you exactly what I'm talking about. So the first one is, as I said before, is to the right, right? So let's say I'm going to make this really big. So let's make it, I have it as a 1 right now. Let's go ahead and make it a 10 so you can really see what I'm talking about. It's going to push it all the way to your right. Okay. So let's go back to 1. The second number is, as I said, from the bottom. So let's go ahead and make that a 20 so you can really see that, right? So that's for the bottom. And then the third number is the shadow. So right now, as I said before, is really compact. But let's say I make that a 10. And you see how it makes that glow just a little bit further out. Okay. So go ahead and play with these to get it to where you would like it to be. So let's go ahead and maybe I might want that. Let me try the 8. I kind of like the 8. Let's bring the bottom up just a little bit more. And I kind of like that. Okay. Let's see here. The shadow, maybe a 6. I like that even better. Okay. So play around with this to get it to where you, how you want it. Okay. And that's what's really fun about this. And remember again, you're only applying this to this section only, this heading only. Okay. So as you can tell, look, if I go ahead and save it and I go to the other sections, you see that it's not in any other section except that one. All right, so let's go back to it. If you ever lose it, go back to your text here and it's right down here. All right, and then the last line where I have, where it says black, So this is the actual color of the shadow, and you can make that as well any color you'd like. So I have it set as black right now, but let's say this brand, I have also used brown. So let me grab that hex color here. All right, and you can paste it here. So you can't really, really tell that much, right? That that is brown. But if I was to make this a one, you can might be able to see the brown a little bit more. Can't really tell it, but trust me, it's a brown. It's the color brown. And so that lightens a little bit more, brown versus the black. Also, you can, there are certain colors that you could use, the primary colors that you can just type in here. Let's say I just want it red. You can actually type the name of the color. Okay, so this is red. Or let's say you want an orange. So some, if I spell it correctly, so you can do that here as well, but I would just advise you to just keep your actual hex colors so that you, the colors are consistent no matter where you are. Okay. So that is it. So I really like the way that that looks. I'm going to go ahead and save it and take a look at it on mobile. You always want to double check everything on your mobile. And there we go. I really, really like that. I might bring that actually slightly change it. Yes. Sometimes that little minor adjustment makes a huge difference. So now let's go ahead and go back, and I'm going to go ahead and copy this and apply it somewhere else. So to show you, so this was the text, rich text section. Let me go ahead and go to the image. Let's do this image text area. Same thing. You click on it and you come down, scroll all the way down to the bottom. You'll see the hex code here. And then let's do the same thing. Just copy and paste that code. And there we go. So here for this section, I would make that smaller. So let's go back to a 3, kind of like that. All right. And then I would definitely make this much, much smaller. So we could either go back to a 2. I don't know. Let's try 1. 1. I like that. I like the 1. Let's see here. Maybe make that a 2. And play around with it, guys, just like I'm doing here. As I'm showing you, I'm just playing around, giving a little bit of depth to that. So let's go ahead and save that, and let's double check it on mobile and see what it looks like on mobile. What do you think? See, makes a little bit of difference. I know that when we're using a Shopify themes, we feel limited, but you don't have to. We can go ahead with custom CSS. We can go ahead and make those little changes that we want to make our site exactly how we want it to look. I think that looks good. What I want to do, I already saved it, always save. What I want to go do is see actual live site. There we go. So it went from this, as you can see, from here to that. And there's the purpose. So on this particular one, next I'm actually looking at it, just the website by itself. I think I might bring in that shadow just a little bit more, but it is up to you exactly how you want to do it. Completely up to you. That's it. Super simple, right? And it was fun. And you can use it throughout your website in a lot of different ways. And these are the little customizations that you can make on your website that will set you apart from other shops. So like and subscribe. And let me know in the comments below what else you would like to learn from me so I can go ahead and continue to make videos that will teach you how to elevate your Shopify website. Until next time, adios.